A bubble chart is an effective way to present data showing three variables. It displays three dimensions of data represented by the x-axis, the y-axis, and the size of the bubble. Have you ever created a three-dimensional chart? Let us understand with the help of an example. John is an analyst in the equity research team of ABC Limited. One evening, his manager comes to him and says, "We need an analysis showing performance of 10 players in the chemical industry. The client call is in the morning tomorrow. We need to show something interesting to them." Now, what can John do? Something which can be done quickly as well as is insightful for the client. The first step or the first thing which John needs to do is to collect the performance data of the top 10 chemical companies. He can do that by pulling the data quickly from databases like Bloomberg or Capital IQ. The data in the Excel here shows data for the top 10 chemical companies in US. We have the revenue numbers for the year 2014 and 2019, and we also have the EBITDA, the earnings before interest, tax, depreciation, and amortization for the year 2019. How can we show this data so that it is interesting as well as insightful for the client? We need to work around the data in such a way that it seems interesting and meaningful for the client discussion. So we will calculate the 5 years revenue growth for the company, the EBITDA margin, and we will show the revenues for the year 2019, because revenue can represent the size of the company. So let us first calculate the revenue growth for the 5 years. Revenue growth can be calculated using the following formula. So we start with the revenues for the year 2019 divided by the revenues for the year 2014 to the power of 1 divided by 5, since it's the revenues for the last 5 years, and minus 1. So what does this mean? So the compounded annual growth rate, or the CAGR, for company Alpha is 2% during last 5 years. The EBITDA margin can be calculated as EBITDA for the year 2019 divided by revenues for the year 2019. We can link revenues for 2019 directly. We will copy and paste these formulas for all the companies. So you press Ctrl C to copy and then select the range and press Alt ESR to paste the formulas. So you get the revenue growth, margins, and revenue for all the companies. Now, what do we do? We need to insert a bubble chart. To insert a bubble chart, we select the data, and then go to insert, we go to charts, all charts, XY scatter plot, bubble chart, and select the bubble chart, press OK. So we have the bubble chart. We'll do a bit of formatting so that the chart looks clean. So I'll select the horizontal grid lines and press delete. Then select the vertical grid lines and press delete. So the chart looks more clean now. Then, to ensure that the data selection is correct, we click on the chart, right click, and then select data. We see series 1. Click on edit. So the X value, what is the X value? X value is the revenue growth for the last 5 years. The Y value is the EBITDA margin. And the size of the bubble is revenues for the year 2019. So that the data has been captured cleanly by Excel. Now, how do we represent the X axis and the Y axis? So we need to insert a text box. So go to insert, text and text box. Here we can type revenue growth. This revenue growth is for the year 2014 to 19, and this is CAGR percentage. This is the x-axis, format it, fit it to the chart. Similarly, we will put the y-axis. Again, we go to insert, text, and then text box. Click on the chart and put EBITDA margin. This is for the year 2019, and this is again in, as a percentage of the revenues. So we have the EBITDA margin, a bit of formatting. Chart title, we can click on the chart title, and then name is as performance comparison for chemical companies. What is missing here? We have the data represented by the bubbles, but we don't know which bubble represent which companies. So we select the bubbles and then right click, add data labels. So we have the data labels, but these levels are again relating to the EBITDA margins. So we need to edit the data labels or replace the data labels with the name of the companies. So we again click on data labels and then select format data labels. Here we select value from cell and then select the cell range as the name of the companies, Alpha Dow Jones, and press OK. Remove the selection Y value and show leader lines and then click OK. So we need to add a legend. So we go to insert, illustrations, shapes, and select an oval. Put the oval on the chart, remove the shape outline to no outline. Then you can add a text box just beside the circle, and there you can write size of the bubble. Represents 2019 revenues. Now this is the bubble chart where we have the x-axis representing the revenue growth for the last 5 years, the y-axis representing the EBITDA margin, and the size of the bubble representing the revenue growth. We have the names. So this analysis or this chart shows that Frago is the largest company in terms of revenue and has delivered the maximum growth, around 10%, whereas Alpha has the highest margin but has delivered a growth of only 2%. Whereas there are a few smaller players like Charlie and Gamma which have delivered low growth and have comparatively low margins. What does John do now? John can copy and paste this chart on a PowerPoint document and present a compelling story with the client. Hope you enjoyed the session. Keep learning and have fun. Thank you.